Hallelujah. Good morning, saints of God, and welcome to another time of Commanding Morning. I'm Minister Cordell McClure. I want you to just lock into Almighty God this morning as we flow, as we give Him praise, as we give Him honor, as we give Him glory, as we magnify His holy name. We're here until 6, just about 6 a.m. So I just want you to just shake off that sleep, you know, just walk around, just stretch a little bit. We're in for an awesome time with Almighty God this morning. I just want you to just go ahead and worship God. Just spend a few minutes telling Him how much you love Him, how much you adore Him. Just magnify His holy name. God is good, you know. Even sometimes when we don't always see the results that we want to see, you know, it could be a bit depressing. You could, get frustrated. But I just want you to know that God is good. He still loves you. The thing is that I always tell people is that God has already made everything available to us. So if for any reason we don't see it happening, then most likely it's something that we are not doing right, or something that is not lining up appropriately, because God has already done what He had to do. So God is not to be blamed when things don't work how we want it to work. Let me just put it that way. But also, it's not a reason for you to be walking around depressing. Maybe it's something, and maybe it's, I did this some time ago, and that is why. No. As I said yesterday, a lot of it is because of that unbelief has been inculcated into our lives, because unbelief is so much a part of our lives that when we ought to really believe, even though we have faith, when we're really supposed to believe, we have not yet come to that place where we can truly, truly believe. Amen? So God is not to be blamed, and I don't want you to be walking around depressed either, figuring that I'm to be blamed. Amen? So just go ahead, just worship Him, magnify His name, tell God how much you love Him, how much you appreciate Him. If you want to just sing a worship song unto Him this morning, telling Him that you worship, just say, Lord, I worship You, I magnify Your name. Hallelujah, You're the Alpha and the Omega. Hallelujah, You're the King of Kings, You're the Lord of Lords. I love You, Lord. I love you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, I bless Your holy name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you just want to say good morning, Lord. Good morning, Holy Spirit. Good morning, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm so grateful that you've kept me. First of all, I'm grateful that You saved me out of that damnation. I'm grateful that You took me out of that miry clay and placed my feet where I can stand, where I can walk, where I can worship, where I can truly represent You, where I can evangelize, where I can, Lord, let people know about Your love, about your grace, about Your mercy. Lord, I thank You, oh God, for sending Your Son to die for us. I worship You this morning. I bless Your holy name. Oh God, there is none like You. Who is like unto Thee, my precious Father? Who is like unto Thee, my Lord, my King, my Savior? Lord, I just bless You. I just bless You, Lord. Oh, come on. It feels like just as a joyous occasion this morning. Hallelujah. Just magnifying my God, just worshiping Him. There is nothing that brings me greater joy than being in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Nothing that brings me greater joy. I just lose myself. It just feels so great. And you just have to bring yourself to that place. I mean, when you look at David, he just said, Lord, I was so happy when they said, let us go into the house of God. Hallelujah. Because he was just a man after God's own heart. God was his everything. He had the kingdom and wives and whatever it is that, you know, we think make us happy. But when you look at how he expressed himself to God, hallelujah, he was a man of worship. He danced like whatever. He just didn't care what happened, who said what. He just had fun in the presence of Almighty God. We are not gonna come into the presence of God and be so restricted. We just want to come and just pour our hearts out to You this morning, Lord. Go ahead. I just want you to receive the spirit of what I'm telling you this morning. Hallelujah. As you come into the presence of God, it's a joyous occasion. There is fullness of joy. There are pleasures. Rabakase. Oh, just worship him. Worship him. Worship him this morning. Hallelujah. I know some of you, you're still waking up. You're still getting there. But just lift your hand. Just go before God this morning and say, God, I'm taking a few minutes just to magnify your name. I'm taking a few minutes just to worship you. I'm taking a few minutes just to exalt you, mighty God, because, Lord God, there is none like you, Jehovah. And I just make room for you in my life, oh God, that you can do as you desire. Lord, because this life is not my own, I refuse to treat it as my own. Oh God, I dedicate my life to you, to service to you, almighty God. Dedicate my life to your kingdom, oh Jehovah. Rebecca Sataya Baba, Roboko Sheke, Roboko Santalaba, Rebecca Yoroboko She, the baby Kisalababa, Kayoroboko She. Lord, I worship you this morning. I exalt your name this morning. There is none like you, Jehovah. Oh, mighty God, there is none like you. Who is like unto thee, precious Father? Who is like unto thee, my Lord, my King, my Savior? Lord, there is none like you. Jehovah, there is none like you. Hallelujah, there is none like you, mighty God. Oh, my King, my Savior, I worship you this morning. Lily of the Valley, I worship you this morning. I bless your name, I bless your name. I exalt you, Lord. I exalt you, Lord. I exalt you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord, mighty God, I worship you. Jehovah, I worship you. Jehovah, I worship you, mighty God. Hallelujah, Lord. How great are you, Lord? Great is your faithfulness. You never fail. You never sleep. You never slumber. You continue to watch over us, almighty God, with a father's love. Almighty God, we just bless you this morning. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, we give you free reign. Wherever your people are watching this morning, we declare it holy ground. We declare it sanctified unto God. We declare it out of bounds to the enemy in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, blessed Father. Listen, I know there's some people with some testimonies from yesterday. Hallelujah. Still waiting for you to text us and call. I am absolutely convinced that there's some people with testimonies from yesterday. If you're watching this morning, hallelujah, you can just give us a call or a text. Let us know that this is what happened. See, testimonies help others to build their faith, to lift their level of faith and cast out that unbelief, because they can now see that this thing is really possible. Amen? So give us your call and let us know that, you know, this is what God did in my life. Never ever hold back your testimony. Don't think it is too small. Listen, if you had a bad cold and you flowed with God and that cold disappeared, that's a testimony. Amen. If you had sinus, if you had a headache for 3, 4, 5 days and it just went just like that, that's a testimony. A testimony is not always all the big things that happen. And you know, and you know, sometimes we like to say that, oh, that's what she's testifying about. No, listen, everything that God does for you is a testimony. Amen. Just the fact that you're alive today is a testimony. God, I'm thankful. I could have been dead. People could have been over at my house with my family, crying with them and giving them support this morning because of me. But you kept me. I'm grateful. And we have to come to that point of developing thanksgiving in our lives. When we, thanksgiving is just a part of everything that we do. You know, the Holy Spirit keeps reminding me over and over that, you know, there are times when you pray for things and this is absolutely not where I was heading this morning, but you pray for things But you don't say thanks until you see it happen. And there are times when I would have prayed for things, and when it happened, I said, God, I thank you. Look, you deliver. You came true for me. And the Holy Spirit said, that thanksgiving should have started long before. Because as you prayed, you are believing that this thing has already happened. And if you're believing that, let's put it this way. Let's say you go to do a job interview. And by the time you finish a job interview, you know that you have the job. There's sometimes you go to a job interview and you know, I have this job. They might even hint it to you. They might even start asking you certain questions that you know, yeah, you get through with the job. And you come out and you start thanking God, that God, you know, I thank you because the interview went well and I got that job and whatever. Even though you don't have the paper yet that says you're employed, start this day, whatever the case may be. Now treat that as a poster. You do the interview, you come out, and 2 weeks later or a month later or whatever, they call you and say, yes, you were successful, start on this date, and then you're saying, thank God. So we have to come to that point where you say, God, as I prayed for something, I know you've done it. I haven't seen the physical manifestation yet, but Lord, I thank you. Because you are God and I know you are prayer answering God. I know you've made everything available to me. I know you've already healed me. It's just for this body to begin to line up and to begin to do that which it is supposed to do. Lord, I know that the finances that I need, you've already provided. So Lord, I thank you. Listen, the objective of the devil is to make Christians walk around depressed. And if you're depressed right now, it has nothing to do with God. I'm telling you, I'm sorry. If you're depressed, it is the fact that the king of lies is feeding you something, right, that is contrary to the word of God. So if you're depressed, well, you have to begin to say, first of all, why am I depressed? Amen? And what does the word of God say about that situation? And then thirdly, you have to begin to confess what the word of God says about that situation. Oh, Rabba Kasete Rebe, Rebe. And then you just have to begin to walk in that authority. Oh, Maka Yoruboko Sheke Sete Rebe. Somebody just begin to thank God this morning. Somebody just begin to say, Lord, I thank you. Think about all the things that you ought to say, Lord, I thank you for. I thank you for life. I thank you for my family, Jehovah. I thank you for my job. Oh, God, I thank you, oh, God, for my business. All the things that you've made available for me, Almighty God, I thank you for them, oh, God. Oh, I thank you, Jehovah. I thank you for the car and all the things that you've provided for me. Lord, I thank you, Jehovah. I thank you for those who made a way for me in some way or the other. Oh, God, Lord, I thank you, Jehovah. I thank you for this land that, Lord, you've decided that this geographic location that we would be in at this time, Almighty God. I thank you for the government that you've put in place and the president and prime minister. Ministers and chief secretary and the secretaries and the assistant secretaries and the permanent secretaries and the administrators and all the staff that, Lord, you've put together in this place. Lord, I thank you, Jehovah. I thank you, Almighty God. I thank you for sanity. Oh, God, that I can wake up in my right mind this morning. I thank you because I can move around. Oh, God, I thank you because my senses are intact. Almighty God. Oh, Jehovah, I thank you. Just thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him for health. Thank him for strength. Oh, Ramakai, Oroboko, Shedebe, Kese, those who are studying, thank him for where you have come to this level. Thank him for the brain. Oh, that you've been able to understand that which is being taught. Listen, don't take for granted anything in your life. It is God, 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 God who makes it available to you. He has provided for you. Don't take it for granted ever. Lord, I just thank you for life. Listen, there's some people who they're moving around quite normal. And then suddenly, they're gone. Amen? So I say, Lord, I just thank you. Sometimes you wake up and there's something wrong with you. So something is, you're getting a pain and the pain isn't going away or whatever. And you're saying, Lord, I'm just not feeling good. But just thank God. Just say, God, I thank you, I'm alive. I know that this will pass. Hallelujah. Because I believe in the healing power of Almighty God. I know it shall pass. But so God, I'm beginning to give you my praise from now. Beginning to shout, I'm beginning to dance, I'm beginning to say some big hallelujahs, I'm beginning to say some big praise you, Lord. I'm beginning to say, Lord, I worship and adore you, I magnify your name because you are great. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord, and you're worthy to be praised, you're worthy to be magnified, you are worthy to be exalted. Oh, great are you, Lord. Great, great. Great are you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, Rababaka Yoramokoshe. Rebeke say, listen. Sometimes we don't understand how important praising God is. Hallelujah. I just believe somebody's dancing this morning and you're just dancing those scales off. You're dancing those shackles off. Rebeke Satayarabaka Yarabokoshe. You're dancing that depression off. Hallelujah. That's the Holy Spirit moving this morning. That's the Holy Spirit shifting things around. Ramaka Yarabokoshe Rebeke Sete. Rabaka Sotorabokoshe. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want us to just check this scripture very quickly. Hallelujah. It just, the Lord has dropped it in my heart as I was coming in the studio this morning. I wanted to share it with you. Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6, from verse 10. It says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the presence of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. And then it goes on to talk about the scripture that, you know, it's quoted a lot, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of darkness of this age, against the spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. Being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. I'll stop there. Listen, as the Spirit of God was saying to me this morning, as children of God, we have to be able to stand, and we have to be able to stand for something. Amen? And if every time Carnival comes, it's a big challenge, and this is not to beat anybody, this is not to make you feel bad, it's to encourage you. But if Carnival comes, and every time Carnival comes, we're in trouble because we just keep finding yourself back into the faith. God is saying that, listen, you ought to stand. Stand and make sure that your feet are firm on the ground. Make sure that your feet are where they're supposed to be. And what it requires really is for us to really develop that deep-rooted relationship with the Holy Spirit, so that when you find yourself drifting, the Holy Spirit will begin to speak to you. In fact, the Holy Spirit is always speaking to you, but he will begin to direct you again. He begin to give you the warning because he knows where you're heading long before you end up there. So when you start having a conversation with somebody, the Holy Spirit will tell you, listen, this is not good for you. And then you now have to take a decision that I am going to stand on the word of God. I'm going to stand with that breastplate of righteousness and so forth. I'm going to stand on the word of God. And I'm going to be rooted. I'm going to be firm in the things that I know that the principles that God has outlined. Amen. In other words, what I'm trying to say to you is in this carnival time, that's the word of God for you this morning. As a child of God, don't get carried away. Don't let the world dictate to you that you're weird if you don't want to jump up in a band. Don't let the world dictate that to you. Amen? Don't let the world dictate that to you. Don't let the world dictate to you that if you don't want to go to a fete, whether you, sometimes friends tell you, you know, let's just go, you're not going and do anything, you're going and dance, you're going to wear, you're just going to watch. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. One of the things that, you know, the Holy Spirit is just reminding me of is that something he taught me a few years ago. Then, the reason why I prefer children of God not to be in certain places is that, one, you're feeding your spirit man with things that it ought not to be fed with. And you have to, at some point or the other, get rid of those things that you're feeding it. And that is why our life becomes a challenge, because you're so weighted with stuff that you should not have received in the first place. There's some people who just feed their lives with stuff all day, day after day, week after week. You're just pumping stuff into your spirit man that you have to get out at some point or the other. For me, I've taken a decision now that maybe it might come over boring sometimes or whatever, but it doesn't make sense pushing all of these things into your system that it's not helping you. So don't let me drift away. So you're in the places that you ought not to be. You're feeding your spirit man. So you're in the fete. You're not dancing. You're not drinking. You're just there. But you're feeding your spirit man all of the garbage that comes with the music and the fete and everything. And also, from a spiritual perspective, And this was confirmed recently when I was watching a video by a satanist who was talking about how they operated. When you're in that fete, you're in the devil's playground. Some people don't like me to say that. They don't like that. That sounds harsh. But I'm telling you, I received the documentary evidence from somebody who operated in the kingdom of darkness, who confirmed that in the fetes, that's when the agents of darkness, they go. And priority number one, they look for Christians. They know, they can tell that you have given your life to Christ. So they go to the fetes, they go to the clubs, and they look for Christians. And all they need you to do is to respond to them. So in other words, it could be a man who could just come and say, I want to have a dance with you. And you just say, no, I'm not dancing. You've given them access because you responded. That I'm just telling you, this is the explanation that was given by somebody who was working for the devil. Amen? And he's saying that once they get that access, they're on the inside. And they can begin to manipulate and affect your life. Amen? And God gave me that revelation a long time ago. But I was thankful for that video to really just give me a little better idea of what it is. And that is why I say you ought not to be in the place you ought not to be. And the Spirit of God just asked me to share with you this morning. I said, listen, child of God, this is a time when a lot of people drift away. You know, sometimes churches are empty because we went out to a fete last night and whatever the case may be. He said, haven't done all. Stand. Stand on the word of God. Stand on his principles. Don't allow yourself to get drifted away. Listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. Listen to that voice of reason. As he tells you, no, child of God, you ought not to be there. Child of God, maybe you need to turn off that television. Maybe you ought not to be looking at that show. Maybe, and it comes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I just want to pray for you this morning, Lord. Your people are before you this morning. They've received that which you've shared, Almighty God, that which you've, oh God, deposited in their system. Lord, we speak activation, oh God, for that which they've received in their system that will help them to stand. Lord, we know you've given them everything that it takes. We know that the power, oh God, that raised Christ Jesus resides in each and every one watching this program this morning, praying with us this morning. Hallelujah. Remember, we do not wrestle against flesh and blood. Hallelujah. So when those challenges come, I keep telling you, fornication, adultery, and all the things that we get into, It's not flesh and blood. It's the devil working his way and deceiving and just causing you to move away from the things of God. That's what sin is, you know. Sin is really to allow you to move away from your place in God. It doesn't make God love you less if you're in sin. It doesn't make him love you less. But what it does, it gives the devil access to your life. It gives the devil right in your life. Because you're saying, devil, listen, as you are really serving. Hallelujah. That's what sin is. Say, Lord, help me to stand. Help me to stand, Jehovah. Help me to stand, even in this time. Even if I don't think that I have a challenge with what is happening right now. Help me to stand, Jehovah. Help me to stand firm. Help me to keep my mind right. My mind focus on you. Lord, and I pray for all your family members who may be experiencing some kind of challenge even in this time and finding themselves in places that they ought not to be. Rebeko Santana Baba Kayanabo Koshe. Rebeko Sotorobo Kosara Baba Kayanabo Koshe. Having done all, stand, stand, stand. That's the word. Having done all, stand. Having done all, stand. Having done all, stand. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We just have about a minute or so left. I want to encourage you to come to TIN's 5th anniversary. It's going to be on the 12th of March at the Lambeau Healing Tabernacle Church. I want to see you out in your numbers there. All those of you who join us for Command Your Morning, come out. Let me know that you watch Command Your Morning. It's going to be from 5 to 7 p.m. at the Lambeau Healing Tabernacle Church there in Lambeau. And we want you to come. You're going to be having a grand time in the presence of Almighty God. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome. We're going to be joining Bishop Allen there to celebrate our 5th anniversary. You don't want to miss it. I want you to continue to pray for TIN. Continue to pray that God will take this channel higher and higher. New territories, new opportunities, new places in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, we just thank you this morning for that which you did. We thank you because having done all, we will stand. Oh God, we will continue to look to you. We will continue, oh God, to be of service to you, oh God. Remember, you are a champion. You are born to rule and reign in this life. Don't let nothing stop you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.